everyone. And I'll try to make this as short and sweet as possible. But I know these two oddballs will probably go off on their own craziness. First, let's talk about the rings. Because they represent more than just a piece of paper signed by the government. Now please, as I read this, I want you to look each other deep in the eyes and imagine your lives
she says,
together in the future.
We're going to make this as serious as possible.
These rings that you have chosen are so much more than decorations on your finger. These rings represent your love. They represent the support that goes along with becoming husband and wife. They represent faith. They represent forever and always. They represent going out in a hail of bullets, no matter what.
Right. Fuck going back to our sales.
Now, Rich, if you would please place the ring on Tracy's finger and read your vow.
I don't want to have it.
Oh, that's the press up.
Sparkly skull.
I'm just gonna zoom in on Corey's face.
Does this go on my ear or my finger?
It goes on mine.
Goes on your ear? Goes on your ear? What?
Oh.
We're supposed to make this special and as serious as possible, and it's not working.
This is long. So. Hopefully. Hopefully, you guys got a lot of time on your hands.
We have a viewer.
Who is it?
Two viewers.
Alright. Ready?
Alright. Three viewers.
So I hate speaking. I'm a better writer than I am a speaker, so hopefully I wrote right. Alright. First of all, I want to say, about fucking time. I think, really, 8 years was perfect, but this is a long time, huh? I'm just... Yeah, so good things, they say good things come to those who wait. Really, girl, we'll see.
Do it.
But they say that the best things come to those who wait. And to us, it's been a long time. That wasn't how it was. It's funny that after 8 years, I could still creep you out, surprise you. And still keep that shock value alive every day.
It's every day, bro, with the Disney Channel, bro.
But that's this thing that keeps the spark alive. Every day you amaze me, and you keep me in wonder. Every day I am thankful to have you in my life. I have loved before. I have shared my life with others in the past. But you are the one, you are the only one that made me feel the way I do every moment of every day. You keep me in line. You keep me out of trouble. You keep me doing stupid shit. You gave me structure. Well, you saved my life. You saved me in more ways than just forcing me to go to the hospital, as I refused. I could have died in that small room on Court Street, doubled over in pain. You made me realize that my life meant more than just breathing, more than just my kids. You taught me how to love again. You taught me how to drop my defenses, allow another person into my life. I walked through the darkness, arms stretched out. I couldn't see anything. Trying to find a light.
Do you have that anything?
And off in the distance, I seen it. But I strayed away in fear that light would be false and I would only be hurt again. And with honesty, as you called out to me, I gave you my dark and I told you it wasn't good enough for you. I told you I wasn't good enough for you, sorry. But as I crept further along, your light came closer. But this time it was behind me. I didn't like that.
Breathe.
But this time the light was behind me, and that light began to light my way until I turned and I saw you standing there in your own darkness, wanting my light. But I didn't know I had any more. I lost thought because I thought I lost it because the darkness surrounded me. Together we... Stupid ass shit. We slept in the light and never looked back. I haven't been perfect, nor have I given you 8 solid years of joy.
You want to bring it up? It's that's the text box.
No, it's good. It's good. I'm just having a hard time reading. I fucked up a few times, taking many things for granted. Every time you stood strong.
This bird is talking more than you.
Told you I'm a terrible speaker. And it showed me again what has always been important. I know I'm an asshole. I wear this pride with this badge with pride. And to be your husband, it cut off. It didn't go all the way.
No.
So anyway. Anyway, it's just you and me, babe. Together we could conquer the world.
Nope.
That's
all. Here you go. Just a little bit. All right. Now, Tracy, if you will please place the ring on Rich's finger and read your vow.
It's really loose. I don't have any more to lose.
Yeah, you do.
Oh, you had yours typed out, printed out.
You know what? I've had these vows written and revised many, many times.
I just wish mine.
Shut up. Okay, so I think I spent the majority of my life searching for the piece of me that I always needed. When I met you, I knew the best fit was perfect. You are my me, and I am your you. I love you for pushing me when I need it. I love you for making me realize that I am so much more than I ever thought I was. And for forcing the cuddles on me when I'm having a crazy, cranky day. I love you for how you take care of me and how you keep me working on being a better... Wait. How you keep working on being a better man even on the days that I fail at being a better woman. You are my person, my safe place, my heart, and the love of my life. I promise to always support you, your thoughts and ideas, even if they might be a little on the crazy side. I promise to always push you when you want to give up and to help you if you ever fall. I promise to love you every day with my whole heart, even on the days when we want to smack each other with rusty spoons.
The rusty hook.
Since the day we met, you and I are fate. Nothing can stop me. You're stuck with me, my love, until you and I die and die again.
Now I ask, Rich, do you take Tracy to be your wife?
Yes.
And Tracy, do you take Rich to be your husband?
I do.
You may kiss the bride, finally.
Yo!
I know you do, man.
Ladies and gentlemen,
I've loved you since the day we met.
I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Richie Boy Palmer.
Richie Boy Palmer? Richie Boy Palmer.
We married!
I don't think it's Boy Palmer though.
That's it.